your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest. On earth, peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King. O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only you have the Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. God our Father, who by sending into the world the word of truth, in the spirit of sanctification, make known to the human race your wondrous mystery. Grant us, we pray, that in professing the true faith, we may acknowledge the Trinity of eternal glory and adore your unity, powerful in majesty. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever.
A reading from the book of Exodus. Early in the morning, Moses went up Mount Sinai, as the Lord had commanded him, taking along two stone tablets. Having come down in the cloud, the Lord stood with Moses there and proclaimed his name, Lord. Thus the Lord passed before him and cried out, the Lord, a merciful and gracious God, slow to anger and rich in kindness and fidelity. Moses at once bowed down to the ground and worshiped. Then he said, if I find favor with you, O Lord, do come along in our company. This is indeed a stiff-necked people. Depart our wickedness and sins and receive us as your own. The word of the Lord. A response, glory and praise forever. Glory and praise forever. Blessed are you, O Lord, the God of our fathers, praiseworthy and exalted above all forever, and blessed is your holy and glorious name, praiseworthy and exalted above all for all ages. Glory and praise forever. Blessed are you in the temple of your holy glory, praiseworthy and glorious above all forever. Glory and praise forever. Blessed are you on the throne of your kingdom, praiseworthy and exalted above all forever. Glory and praise forever. Blessed are you who look into the depths from your throne upon the cherubim. Praiseworthy and exalted above all forever. Glory and praise forever. A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, rejoice. Mend your ways. Encourage one another. Agree with one another, live in peace, and the God of love and peace will be with you. Greet one another with a holy kiss. All the holy ones greet you. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him might not perish, but might have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but
that the world might be saved through him. Whoever believes in him will not be condemned, but whoever does not believe has already been condemned because he has not believed in the name of the only Son of God. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So today we celebrate Trinity Sunday. It's good to be back in church to see everyone. You may, those that like to watch sports on TV like I do, going through withdrawal the last couple of months, right? But it had baseball starting, NBA playoffs, hockey playoffs. Right now it's all gone. But anyways, it made me think of the passage we heard today. We heard our gospel from John 3:16-18. In John 3:16, God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whosoever might believe in him will have eternal life and not perish. Some people, you know, pick one verse of the gospel, different places, say that sums up the message of Jesus. So there's, you know, different places where people pick something out. This is one that a lot of people say, that sums up the message of the gospel. You know, God loves us so much, he sent Jesus, and you believe in him, you'll have eternal life. So yeah, it's good news. And this is one connecting with all the sports stuff that a lot of people, they say this, if people would believe this passage, you might get converted. So what do? They take a big sign, says John 3:16. You take it to like NFL football game, or they used to try to take it to the NBA, and they would hold it up there, and then people would be thinking, somebody at home watching the game might see it, and maybe they'll look this up and repent and get themselves straightened out. So kind of interesting, but I know at one point the NFL didn't want anyone advertising religion. And so, you know, they used to show the end zone when people were kicking a field goal. They would show the end zone, the goalposts, and behind the end zone are all these seats. And these people would get those seats and have a big sign, John 3:16. So then the NFL said, we don't want that going on there. So now they switched to the camera in the end zone, looking out at the kicker. So nobody can see that. But people still persist in that. But anyways, this is a great message of the gospel. There's a lot of different verses we could say. This sums things up. You know, love one another as I have loved you. Jesus told the apostles that. But we think about today's feast. It's the Holy Trinity. So we say each person in the Trinity, they're all together, three persons in one God, but each has their own kind of distinctive function. So we say the Father's the Creator. He's the one who created everything. The Son, the Redeemer. And the Holy Spirit, the one who sanctifies and watches over the church and guides us. So we think of the Father. We say, he is the origin, the first origin of everything, is our teaching. At the same time, he's the goodness, love, and care for all of his creation. So that goodness, love, and care is why we send Jesus. You know, the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. So he sent Jesus. You say, God the Father does not have a body. Jesus is the one that, as physical being, took on our flesh, thanks to the gift of the Virgin Mary. So he could enter into our life in a very close, personal way and redeem us. And so we're very thankful for that. And that's what our gospel says. Then we have the Holy Spirit sanctifying us. And so we say, the Father and the Son send the Holy Spirit into our hearts when we get baptized, we receive the indwelling of the Trinity. So we have this. Jesus said, the Holy Spirit is like an advocate that really helps us and make decisions in everyday life, figure out how God's calling us to follow him. So it's a wonderful feast. It's kind of hard to understand. You know, all the great theologians said, you don't really wrap your mind around God. He's much greater than us. But it's a beautiful mystery. It's a mystery of love. So there's that famous saying, love is not a problem to be solved. It's a mystery to be lived. So we say the Holy Trinity is a mystery we live. That God is this wonderful, kind of like God's a community. He calls us to share that love and goodness of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. So we say yes to what God is doing. And of course, then we enjoy that goodness that God gives us. He saves us. And also then I call to live that way and share that love just as Jesus gave himself for us. So today we are thankful for all of God does, and of course we're thankful to be back and have the Eucharist. Let us stand and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son was adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We bring our prayers now before our loving God, knowing that He has sent Jesus to us to help us and to save us. We pray for the church throughout the world, drawn from all nations and languages. May our triune God guide and sustain us as we proclaim the goodness of the kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord. For all civil power and authority, may the Holy Spirit enkindle in their hearts our servant leadership. May it help all our leaders, create harmony in our nation, and also help us get through the pandemic. We pray to the Lord. For those who bring trials and challenges in life, may they be uplifted by the loving presence of God and the support and compassion of the community of faith. Let us pray to the Lord. For all of us gathered here to worship our holy God, may the communion of love be outpours, preserve us in faith, increase us in holiness. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who have died, that they will enter into God's heavenly rest, and especially today for all living and deceased members of St. Calistus, we pray to the Lord. Let us add our intentions now. Holy God, great beyond all our imaginings, we rejoice to call ourselves your sons and daughters. We ask you to hear these prayers through Christ. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you through the divine work of human hands. It will become our spiritual gift. Thank you. the same Spirit graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we were nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit and become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, St. Callistus, all the glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on this constant intercession in your presence, we realize your unfailing help. May this sacrifice our reconciliation and prayer, Lord, against the peace and salvation of all the world, be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Lawrence, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourselves all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give mind and witness to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the same command and form of divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil." Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, graciously grant peace in our days, by the help of your mercy. We may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait for the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, I said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper. Let us pray. May receiving this sacrament, O Lord our God, bring us health, the body and soul, as we confess your eternal Holy Trinity and undivided unity through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended. We'll say our prayer for spiritual communion for those that might be listening at home, so just bear with me. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot receive you at this moment sacramentally, come Holy Spirit into my heart and embrace you as if you